Alright guys, I'm Spud Gunn and welcome back to another episode of Crash Landing. Now, in today's episode, we're hopefully going to set up an automatic sifter. I've kind of made a start on it already, and we've already kind of got one over there, but this one is going to be for gravel and sand. So if you put cobblestone in a pulverizer, that will turn it into gravel, and you also get sand as a byproduct. And we basically have unlimited amounts of cobblestone. We've got a generator coming straight into here, so all we have to do is take the cobble from here and put it into this barrel here. So it's a lot easier than having to go out and collect loads of dust. But I may also have this sift dust as well, so we'll go and take all the stuff that we've got over at our other sifter and bring it over here so we can fully automate that. Also, we're going to work on a second mob spawner. I've already kind of made a start on it. Also, I've put some walls around here, and I've done a little bit of extra work to this setup. I've kind of automated this. I'll show you that in a second. But first, let's go down another level and check this out. So this is the second mob spawner. This one will basically just be a dark room spawning everything and anything it wants to. These holes are going to be for fans. I've actually made a few here, but we're going to need a lot more. So open blocks fans. They basically will push mobs to wherever you want them to be pushed. Be aware that they do require a redstone signal. So if you just place it down, it's not going to do anything until you give it a redstone signal. So I have got loads of redstone stuck behind these walls. So it's basically going to push me and any mob that spawns here. It's going to push it this way. And I'll have some here, which will push them this way. And the grinder is just about here behind this wall. So hopefully all the mobs will get pushed to this area and get killed by the grinder. Let's just take these out quickly. Another cool thing about these is they'll actually place like diagonally on blocks, which is really cool, really useful. Anyway, let's get started with the sifter stuff first. So let's go to the top floor and head over to our crashed ship so we can get all the stuff that we need and bring it over. It may require a couple of trips because I need to take some full chests with my dollies, which can be a bit of a pain in the butt, but that's okay. So we're going to need this autonomous activator. I believe I can just break it with a pickaxe, but just in case, I'm going to pop it off with my battle wrench, which is basically a crescent hammer. Also, let's take our vacuum hopper. I'll probably switch the generator for this auto packager out for a ender generator because it's a lot quicker, a lot more power can be... I think it stores the same amount of power, but it pumps out a lot quicker. And let's grab one of these chests with our dolly. And hopefully if we put that in our golden bag of holding, it's not going to give us a slowness effect. Yeah, that's great. So let's head over here and we can start setting that up. So basically I'm just going to have the autonomous activators obviously sifting gravel, sand, dust, just as it was back there. But I'm going to have three of them in the hope that it's going to go a lot quicker. I'm not too sure if that is actually the case or if that's going to work. Let's just turn that so it's facing the right way. That's the right way. Okay, and we're also going to need our vacuum hopper just here, I believe. And then we'll have a chest here. Or do we want the chest? Yeah, we'll have the chest there. Auto packager here. That sounds about right. Let's get our chest out. Which chest did I pick up, actually? Hopefully it was the first one. Let's put that there. Let's see what's in it. Yeah, that's the first one, the one that this vacuum hopper is going to be outputting to. So let's switch the output to that right-hand side. And that is item output. Cool, so that should output anything into this chest. Let's just check it out. Indeed it does. Then next to that we want our auto packager. And I'll probably have my ender generator here. In fact, I still need to make one of those, don't I? Ah, I forgot about that. Yeah, I still need to make a second ender generator. I should have really done that in between episodes. Anyway, also we're going to need that second chest just here. So let's go and grab that quickly. And also the barrel full of dust. I think I'm going to bring that over so that we can just pump stuff into the autonomous activators or pump dust in there as well. As well as gravel and sand. So let's grab the other chest. Okay, let's put that right next to this auto packager. So if you don't know how this works, basically It will take inventory, it will take items from one inventory, i.e. a chest, and craft it in a 3x3 or a 2x2 and put it in another inventory. So like it's going to take the gravel from here and turn it into blocks or sand. It does require power, and I'm not too sure which. I think we've actually got it set up opposite, so it's probably going to take this stuff and put it into there. I may have to switch that up. I think you just have to kind of turn this around. Yeah, I think it might be like that we need it. Not too sure about that. Anyway, let's go get that barrel of dust as well. Okay, we got the barrel. I think I'm actually going to try it like this, have the chest going up instead so that we've got a little bit more room and we can place the barrel just there. Hopefully this thing won't take anything out of that barrel. I don't think it will. And we can put an item duct here and pump the dust straight into that. So let's do that. We will need another pneumatic servo. I believe I made quite a few of those in between episodes though. I can't remember where I put them though. Aha, there they are. So let's just stick that in there and set it to ignore redstone. Cool, and that should just pump out all the dust it wants into this guy. I think that's going to work anyway. Is it not going to work? Oh no, we need to have the top as an input, obviously, otherwise that's not going to work. Now, dust should start coming in. There we go. Oh, are you right-clicking? I do not want you to right-click. Let's set that to high for now until we want that to start working. Okay, we also need to start powering this and work out which inventory it's taking to where. So I'm just going to go and make that ender generator quickly. I guess we could just use the survivalist generator for now and set up the ender generator in between episodes. It's not too important to have excess power, although this thing will run a lot quicker if we have a lot of power. So let's jump up there and put that there. So that should start transferring energy over. And this should start taking stuff. If I put some iron in there, is that going to take it and start putting it into iron blocks? It is. Cool, so that's set up just the way we want it. And this is pretty much ready to go. Now all we need to do is set that to ignore and flick this lever off so that all of these guys start working. And yeah, so as I said, pulverizer takes cobble, turns it into gravel and sand as a byproduct. This thing is going to sift it. Let's actually turn these to randomly use items. That's better. And it's going to be a choice of gravel, sand or dust that it's going to sift. Everything's going to go into here and that's going to get crafted into blocks of some kind and put into here. Then we can take these and smelt them down if we want. I may also automate that once I get my smeltery over here, or maybe even just a redstone furnace will be easier. But I prefer a smeltery because then we can double ores, obviously, and that's a lot better. Okay, so that's pretty much set up. Let's go quickly show you what I did out here. So basically, I took the liquid pyrothium that we had in the other half of the crashed ship, and I moved it over here so that my water production is a bit quicker. So lava, with a crucible over lava, I think it works at like 0.2 millibuckets per tick. With the source block of liquid pyrothium, it works at 0.7 millibuckets per tick, so it's a lot faster. Burns through these leaves a lot quicker, but it will set the ground on fire. So I've basically half slabbed the ground so that it can't set stuff on fire. And the cobblestone generator is still working exactly the same. I just extended the fluid ducts and item ducts out a little bit to add the liquid pyrothium. Let's go inside before bad stuff starts spawning. Cool, so that's pretty much set up and ready to go. All of these are working. I've charged up my jetpack. I also went in between episodes, I also went to the city and harvested a bunch of blocks and stuff. So I basically tore down an entire building, got some fantasy blocks, some loads and loads of factory blocks, which is how I managed to get some fantasy blocks up here and also add a wall to this thing, because that is quite a lot of fantasy blocks. I also added this nice little trim. Looks quite cool. So to finish this thing off, we're going to need a bunch of fans and also some dark glass, because I don't have any more dark glass. Well, I do. I've got like like 4 blocks or so. It's really not enough to finish this, obviously. So we're going to have to make some more. And for that, we are going to need loads and loads of wool. Luckily, from when I set up my original mob grinder, mob spawner thing, I had tons and tons of string, so I just used that string to make some wool. And in here, we're going to make some blackout curtains. That's probably a lot more than I actually need, but I'm going to make that just in case. And also some fans. So I think I need 19, exactly 19 of these. So to craft them, it's cobblestone slab, ingot of iron, and iron bars. Quite simple. And to craft these blackout curtains, let's actually just search them up quickly. It's not the blackout curtains we need, is it? It's dark glass that we need to search up. So to make that, you need 4 blackout curtains, a piece of glass. Oh, does it have to be thickened glass? I did not know that. Okay, let's grab some sand from here. And we can actually make the thickened glass, because I didn't actually realize that we needed that. Also made some glass, didn't I? Let's grab that. Okay, so I think it said sandy glass we need, so that was two glass and 2 sand. Gives us 4 sandy glass per thing. Whoa, that is a lot, quite a lot more than I need. Let's throw those in the redstone furnace, and that should cook up into hardened glass, thickened glass even. We also need some ink sacs, so I was farming some squid plant seeds to get some squids, and I've got a bunch of ink sacs. So, we've got pretty much everything we need. We just need to wait for that thickened glass to cook up. So, I'm going to wait for this to finish smelting. Okay, I think that should be enough for now. 12 pieces should do. I think I'm going to need more ink sacs anyway to make some more. So, just like this, we put 4 dark glass and then ink sacs in the corner. And that'll give us 2 blocks per thing, so that should give us 8. I believe that is nowhere near enough. We need more squid, more ink sacs, sorry. Let's eat a chicken pot pie. That's some tasty goodness. Okay, let's grab some bone meal if I've got some around here. That might not be enough, but that'll do for now. And let's go and harvest some squids. So if you don't know how to do this, basically just 3 bone meals on a squid plant seed should pop out a squid. And then obviously we can kill him for ink sacs. Let's plant those again. And I'm going to go get some more bone meal and farm a few more squid sacs. Squid sacs? Ink sacs, sorry. Okay, that should be enough. I've got another 19 of those, so let's make some more dark glass. That should make us another 8, and hopefully 16 blocks is enough. So let's go down to our second mob spawner, and we can start setting this up. So we need the fans placed down here. I think I'm going to set these higher ones up first. Let's get some cobble so we can get up there. And basically I've got a lever like under this block, or this block I think actually, and then... Actually, no, it's on top of this block, and then redstone just running across it, so it powers every block. Pretty simple. Pretty easy to do. Let's go up to the top layer. And we can set up these fans. Please don't blow me off. Oh, I knew you were going to do that. Right, let's get our jetpack on. Try and make this a bit easier. Whoa, you're still going to blow me with the jetpack. Okay. Okay, I did not realize that. This is going to be a pain. Okay, so I had to kind of turn the redstone signal off because it was being a pain and it was blowing me all over the place. So we've got those off and we've got the fans placed now. I just need to place the last ones on this side, so we need 2 more and turn the redstone signal back on. So hopefully we can do that without getting blown all over the place. Where is the lever? It's just up there. This might be a pain. Let's do that. Okay, I may have to actually go up above the spawner to do this, but that's okay. Let's just put that down. Get the fan there. Actually, hang on. I'm probably going to need to turn this lever on before I place this fan down. Nope. Please don't blow me all over the place again. All right, that's good. Let's do it with this one as well. So let's power that. Good stuff. We've got all the fans down. We just need to go back up and power that last lever. Okay, let's get rid of this cobble and make it look pretty again. Yeah, I had a lot of trouble. As you can see, it just, every time, you can't even jump without it blowing you back, which is a pain. I tried using the jetpack. It was equally as painful. Okay, so let's also get these last four placed on this side, so it blows everything to the side with the grinder. Man, there is nothing that is going to escape these fans, is there? I even tried blocking them off with cobble, and it still worked. It was still blowing me all over the place. Let's try and get over here. Come on, I literally cannot get past this point, which is going to be a pain trying to get these torches out. Yeah. Come on. Literally, it's physically impossible to get past this block here. Wow. I did not expect these things to be so powerful. Okay, so I need to turn these levers off because the fans are just so powerful that I literally cannot place the last few fans. So let's turn these off, and then we can actually work on stuff. All right, let's put that lever back. Okay, let's go back to the front, and we can place the last two fans. So basically, with this wall of fans here, I literally could not get past this point. As hard as I tried, I could not get past that point. So had to get rid of them quickly. And let's get rid of all this cobble. Even blocking them off did nothing. Still blowing me through the blocks. Okay, let's place the last two down here. And now we're pretty much good to go. We need to break out the torches, get the dark glass in, and power these fans back up. So let's put the dark glass in. Hopefully we've got enough. Just so that it's relatively safe if anything decides to spawn straight away, which I doubt it will. And that is not enough dark glass. We need another 1, 2, 3. We need another 9 blocks. Okay, so let's go and farm some more of those. Some more squid and get some more dark glass. Okay, so we've got enough dark glass to finish this. I did not expect this to be such a pain in the butt to set up. Right, let's get those down. I'll leave this hole off-centered so we don't go up and down on the elevators while we're trying to jump in and do some stuff. These guys are still blowing me this way. Right, we need to go and power these. First, I think I'm going to take out the torches, so let's do so. And it should be dark enough for things to spawn. And the reason I've got all these fans in is because the grinder works in a 5x5 area. And this room is quite a lot bigger than 5x5. I think it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7x7 or 7x9, I think. So yeah, we need something to push them towards this area where the grinder is. We could use conveyor belts or something similar, but I think that looks kind of ugly. And these fans look really cool like that. Kind of like air vents or something, so I decided to use fans, and they're relatively cheap to make as well, so fans are pretty good to use. Let's go up and turn those fans on. So lever here, and there should be some more down here. I should probably also get a torch down here so that I don't get any stupid bats spawning down here. That would be a pain in the butt. Yeah, let's turn that one on. Let's go up, turn the next one on. Oh, wait, is that one? Wait, I've missed one. Aha, that's the one I missed. Cool, let's go up. They should all be running now. So, the basic setup of this, let's actually check they're running quickly before I do the basic setup. Yep, looks like they're all spinning, so that should be working. Everything should get pushed to here where the grinder is. The grinder kills stuff. Any items should come out into this item duct. I've whitelisted this guy here so that it only takes gunpowder, puts that into the reactant dynamo. Also, mob essence will go into the reactant dynamo, and any extra mob essence should go up this pipe here. I'll show you where that goes in a second. Any extra items will go into this trash can and just get deleted. Basically, a trash can. Anything that goes in there will just get deleted forever. So watch out. You don't put anything valuable in that. Up here. Wow. Are these fans actually pushing me through these walls? Are you serious? That is crazy. I can't even get up the ladder. Okay. Well, let's use our jetpack and fly up. Thank you. So the pipe goes up here and over here, and any excess mob essence that can't go in the reactant dynamo should go into our auto spawner up here. Stop pushing me. Which is basically what we wanted this second mob spawner to do, because we need lots and lots of mob essence to power this auto spawner. So that should work quite well, and any extra that can't go in the mob spawner, the auto spawner, sorry, should go into this portable tank, and if we flick the switch, that will send it out to our open blocks tanks for enchanting and other stuff like that. So this should work, although obviously it's not going to spawn anything in here unless I get quite far away, far enough away for stuff to actually spawn. But if we look, it's all red, stuff can definitely spawn in there, we just need to get far enough away so that it does. Let's get our camel pack back on. And let's go up and I'll show you what happens with the enchanting stuff. So any extra mob essence will go into here if it doesn't fit in the auto spawner. And that can be used to do enchanting stuff like I showed you in the last episode. So what I've got set up here is basically stuff for the disenchanter. It's kind of automated. Also upgraded to an ender generator. Because this will take quite a lot of power. So basically any... let's grab an example or a couple of example items. So let's get these chain boots and these leather boots. Any item you throw in this chest should go into the auto disenchanter. That will strip it from of enchantments and it will pump the books out to this oak bookcase, not bookshelf. I think it should pump stuff into there, and the armor, if it doesn't break, the armor will go into this chest, and we basically just have to clear the stuff out of that and get rid of it. As I said in previous episodes, if you want it to strip all the enchantments off, you have to put repeat yes on, and then it will strip everything out or every enchantment off it before it puts it in this chest. Good to know. So let's try it out. Let's throw these leather boots in there. They should get taken out. Put into the disenchanter. That should take loads and loads of power and eventually strip off the enchantment. So let's wait for that to happen. Okay, this thing should be just about to finish. I really need to upgrade this leadstone energy cell into a hardened energy cell so that it outputs more power and this will work quicker. The boots came out, the book came out, the book went straight into the bookcase, which is good, and the boots went into the chest because they didn't break. Great, so that works perfectly. I could have, like, if we didn't want to keep this ruined armor, this like kind of used armor, we could put a trash can here and it shouldn't put anything into there. I guess we could actually filter it so that it only takes books into there, or that it doesn't take books into here, so that if we have a trash can it won't delete any of our enchanted books. That would be annoying. So yeah, that works perfectly. Or as best as I could hope. Now we need to kind of get far enough away so that this thing starts spawning stuff and we can check it out. So let's kind of head over. Actually, let's go grab that leadstone energy cell and we can upgrade it while we're waiting for stuff to spawn. So let's grab that. All we need is 4 invar, I believe, to upgrade this. So that's quite easy to do. I should have some invar somewhere around here. Probably going to, I've got 1 ingot there. Yeah, it's probably in my smeltery chest. So let's grab it quickly. Is there any invar? There is loads of invar, so we only need 4, I think. Let's just check. Yep, only 4 ingots. Let's get to a crafting table and we can set that up. So leadstone energy cell, a few invar ingots, and we have a hardened energy cell. It keeps the power, but obviously it can store a lot more, so that's why the bar is smaller. Looks like it's got less power. It's got the same power, it just can store more. And let's put that back there. It should have the same outputs. Let's just check it's still outputting. Here it is. Cool, and we can upgrade this or up the output so that it outputs a lot more stuff. Cool, and now it's working on this this chain boots one. I don't think I really need a thorns one enchantment though, so I'm just gonna get rid of these boots for now. Cool, now I don't think this has spawned anything. Oh, it spawned some bats, which just died. That's the main reason I've got all these fans up high, is so that any bats that spawn can get killed, hopefully, and come over here. Let's go up. Probably won't get a lot of stuff spawning in there anyway, because we've got loads of mobs outside. Let's just check the nutritional value of that. That's good. So, let's just move away quickly, and hopefully we can get some stuff to spawn. And then maybe I'd like to look at some upgrades for the pneumatic craft helmet. I believe you can install some upgrades on that, which will be pretty cool. Entity tracker, a block tracker, an item search, coordinate tracker, range. Be interested to see what some of these upgrades actually do. I'm not too sure what the item search does. Whoa. Seems quite hard to make, though. Actually, no, that's probably not too hard to make. That might be a bit hard to make. We may do that in the next episode. I'm not too sure. I was actually hoping to head over to another city in this episode. Or in the next episode, sorry. There is more than one city, which is quite cool. Not too sure how many they are. How many there is, even. Okay, so apparently this range upgrade is used in the pneumatic helmet. It seems quite easy to make. I think we're going to try one of those. So we need a bow and four arrows. I may have used all my string for the wool. No, there's some there. So let's take three string. Let's make a bow quickly. I do not have any wood. Okay, I've got a fresh bow and I've got some arrows. Let's get four lapis. Aha, perfect. Four of those, and we should be able to make this range upgrade and check it out, see what it does. Where are the arrows? There we are. Four arrows and four lapis should give us the range upgrade. I have no idea what it does, but apparently it's used in the pneumatic helmet, universal sensor, air cannon, and a security station. Are we out of water? Yes, we are. Let's just quickly fill up. Okay, so let's get our pneumatic helmet, wherever I left that. I think it's in one of these chests here. I really need to get a storage system set up. Probably do some applied energistics storage. Maybe not just yet, though. Insert in charging station to install upgrades. Okay, so my charging station is up here. This guy needs pressure. Alright, let's put the pneumatic helmet in there and... Aha, let's go inventory and there we place the upgrades for the helmet. Okay, 0.8 bar of pressure. I think that should be ready to go. So let's try that on. Oh yeah, one machine upgrade range. Cool. I'm not too sure what that does. I think that may only work with other upgrades. I guess... it will increase the range of the tracker or the entity tracker. Not too sure. It doesn't really seem to be doing much at the moment. So maybe we'll make another upgrade. Okay, I don't have any spider eyes. So let's head over to our old chests where we had our old mob spawner. And hopefully we've got some spider eyes in there. I'm not too sure. We do have loads of stuff in there still. So let's check quickly. Loads of gunpowder, loads of string, as I said. Spider eye. Whoa, yes, there's a lot of spider eye. Okay, so now we can make the fermented one. Let's eat something quickly. And it seems on the minimap that spawner that I just made is only spawning bats at the moment. Or maybe it's just killing everything else so quickly that only the bats are remaining. That could be a problem. Let's just go down and check if there's anything in there. Oh yeah, we've got a skeleton and a zombie hiding just over here. Let's take a quick seat and we can watch. Yep, zombie died. The skeleton's kind of hiding in the corner, so I may have to add another fan in that corner to blow stuff into this corner where it can be killed. But it is working. It doesn't seem to be killing the bats too well. Oh, hello, spiders. I hate you so much. I may also put like some iron spikes in the corner or something just to get rid of these spiders. Maybe even another grinder. I'm not too sure. I probably made this a bit too big for what it needs to do. Should have made it just like 5x5. But that's okay. I wanted it to be big so we hopefully get more mobs spawning in there. Let's actually go up and check our auto spawner. And see how much mob essence we've got stored in there. Oh, I forgot about the stupid fans pushing me all around. Let's fly up. Oh, we've already got some overflowing into our thingy, our tank. Yep, it's quite a lot in there. Cool, so it is definitely working. Let's go and make that fermented spider eye and the other upgrade. Okay, so sugar, mushroom, and spider eye will give us fermented spider eye. We need 4 bones, which I did not think about. Let's go bounce over here quickly. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I think we need another 4 lapis, it said. So I think I've got that. We had like a block in our other chest. Am I really out of water already? No, I'm wearing my jetpack. Okay, I believe there was a block of lapis in here. Good stuff. Let's put half of that back in there. Okay, let's make the other upgrade and check it out, see what it does. So, 4 lapis in the corners, a fermented spider eye there, and some bones. And that gives us the entity tracker upgrade. So, let's put our helmet back in that charging station. And we can go into the inventory, install another upgrade. Cool, let's take it out and see what that does. Now, I assume it's just going to, like, basically put, like, a marker over any entities that are around us. Ooh. That is so cool. Chickens. It's registering our chickens and the mushroom. Health. This animal can be bred. Target. Okay. That is so cool. Man, I wish I had played with Pneumatic Craft sooner. This is like one of the coolest mods I've ever seen. Are you going to track creepers or no? Please tell me you track... Oh, it's tracking the skeleton. Please don't shoot me, bro. Oh, you shot me. Yep. Oh, hello. Hello. Cool, so it does track enemy or unfriendly mobs as well. You just kind of need to get close enough for them to register. That is so cool. Let's actually kill this skeleton as well, because I believe there is a task where I wanted to kill... Did it actually have a... I swear it just had a warning, like, in the top corner saying skeleton behind you or something like that. That was really cool. Okay, so I think I might play around with this helmet a bit more in future episodes and see what some of the other upgrades do. Man, this is cool. Small spider. Yeah, you come over here. Hopefully you get killed. Get killed. Okay, that is so cool. I may actually take this to the next city that we go to, if we go to another one. I think I'm going to at least go and try and scout one out in the next episode. Maybe not explore it too much, because it is obviously really dangerous, but I'd like to at least scout one out. That's pretty much all we've got time for in today's episode. In the next one, as I said, we might go and check out a city or something, or maybe do some quests. I haven't even looked at my quest book in this episode, so we'll think about that. We'll do some other cool stuff. The mob spawner seems to be working nicely. This helmet is the coolest thing I've ever seen. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to leave a like. Really helps me out. Thank you so much for watching, as always, guys, and I'll see you next time.